At the recent ASCO virtual meeting, we presented the ALLIANCE alternate trial. So this is the phase 3 neoadjuvant endocrine therapy study, you know, in patients with newly diagnosed clinical stage 2 or 3 estrogen receptor positive HER2 negative breast cancer. So the goal of the study actually is to develop a biomarker approach in the neoadjuvant setting so that we can identify women who have endocrine-sensitive disease that chemotherapy could be avoided, and also to study endocrine-resistant tumors and identify patients with endocrine-resistant tumor early so that more aggressive treatment could be given. So a primary objective of the alternate trial is to prospectively validate modified preoperative endocrine prognostic index of 0 as an indication of endocrine sensitivity so that patients with a modified PEPI score of 0 could avoid chemotherapy. And what we mean for modified PEPI score of 0 are those patients who had neoadjuvant endocrine therapy, and then at the time of surgery, they had a pathologic stage 2 T2 or below, like 5 centimeter or less tumor, and with a negative axillary lymph node, and Ki-67, which is a proliferation marker, being very low. So in previous studies of neoadjuvant trials, in retrospective analysis of patients who were followed up in those neoadjuvant studies, it was shown that patients with modified PEPI score of 0 had an excellent long-term outcome, that chemotherapy could be avoided. But these were retrospective analysis. So alternate trial is to prospectively validate whether these women would have excellent long-term outcome, so that, you know, chemotherapy could be avoided. And the second primary objective is to compare 3 different endocrine therapy. And these include the standard of care anastrozole, and also 2 investigational treatments. One is fulvestrant, the other is fulvestrant in combination with anastrozole. So both are, you know, shown to be superior in the metastatic setting than the anastrozole alone in the metastatic setting, you know, as primary, as the first-line treatment in patients with endocrine-naive tumors. So we hypothesized that fulvestrant continuing regimens could be more superior than anastrozole, so that more patients would have a modified PEPI score of 0 at the time of surgery, so that chemotherapy could be avoided. So we enrolled 1,362 patients, and women were randomized 1:1:1 ratio to receive one of the 3 different endocrine therapy, anastrozole or fulvestrant, or the combination of anastrozole and fulvestrant. Patient received therapy for 6 months, unless they have a Ki-67 over 10% at week 4, when we do a biopsy of the tumor to make sure that the tumor proliferation is low. So the study found that approximately 20% of the patients, after 6 months of neoadjuvant endocrine therapy, they would have a modified PEPI score of 0. And these women were recommended not to receive adjuvant chemotherapy in the trial. And there was no difference in fulvestrant or fulvestrant in combination with anastrozole when compared to anastrozole in inducing the number of patients with the modified PEPI score of 0. Or we also call it endocrine-sensitive disease. In addition, we found that the disease progression rate is very low. It's about 1% across the different treatment arms. This is reassuring since currently with the COVID-19, a lot of times surgery need to be delayed. And we also would like to avoid chemotherapy since it could cause myelosuppression and immune suppression. So neoadjuvant endocrine therapy in this regard is safe. However, there is a caveat that we did do a 4-week biopsy after the neoadjuvant endocrine therapy started it. So, and those with high Ki-67 were triaged to receive chemotherapy. So those women, we do not know whether they would have had a higher rate of disease progression. But in a subset analysis, when we look at patients who had a very low rate of progression of proliferation at baseline, so for example, if they had a KCT7 less than 10%, then at 4 weeks, when we did a repeat biopsy for KCT7, their KCT7 usually is still less than 10%, and they were able to remain on their assigned endocrine therapy. So this indicates that women with low proliferative tumors to begin with, they would not need to do a 4 week biopsy. The study essentially we're at the follow up phase now and waiting on the relapse free survival data. So that using this neoadjuvant approach to be able to identify those with multiple PEPI score of 0 and then to avoid chemotherapy for these women.